Okay, so in this video, what we're aiming to do is we're going to be creating a walking character using a frame-by-frame animation. We are going to learn how to import images to the stage, and then we're going to convert them to symbols and use the library panel to organize them, and we're going to also investigate some timeline controls. So on the timeline for future reference, if you need to review any of these, they are all going to be shown in this video. We're going to show you onion skins, onion skin outlines, edit multiple frames, center frame, loop, and modify markers. Okay, so we're going to build this walking cycle. This is a brief one that I have put together using fireworks. So it's repeating over and over again and staying in the same place. So this is what we're going to do. Now, to get images for a walk cycle, the typical length for one of these is about 8 frames. So if you go online, go onto the internet, make a Google search for walk cycle, you'll probably find a lot of images that you can save. Alternatively, you can go to the walk cycle capture video that I've created. The link should be showing up right now, and then screen capture all frames from this walk cycle. So I'll hide this and we'll go to Flash. So this is after you have downloaded your walk cycle that you're going to use, and they all need to be separated into separate images. So what we're going to do is create an ActionScript 3.0. First thing we're going to do is go to File, Save As. You should be saving this in your Chapter A folder, so I'm going to call this one walk cycle, and then put your initials after it, then I'll save. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we're going to import those files to the stage. So we're going to go to File, Import, and then Import to Stage. Okay. So if you have these downloaded, they should be showing up in the correct order here. If you use the screenshot method. Otherwise, make sure that they are in the correct order. So I'm going to open this first one, and what I'm going to do right away is I'm going to go to make sure it's selected, go to Modify, Convert to Symbol, and keep it as a graphic, and this one will be Walk 01. 01 is a good idea in case you have more than 8 frames, like if you've got a 12 or 16 frame walk cycle. So it is now a graphic. What we can do is up at the top right, we're looking at the properties right now, but we can look at the library, and down here I've got walk 01. So we can actually delete this from the stage. So I clicked on it and hit the delete key, and we still have that image that I can drop onto my stage. So that's really useful. So what I'll have you do is import the rest of them, convert them to graphic symbols, and then I'll show you the next part. So take a couple minutes, import them all, change them into graphic symbols, and then we'll move on. Okay, so what you should have is your library looking like this. So I've got all of my bitmap images, so all of the screenshots here are organized from first to last in order of their name. That's how it's alphabetized. And then I have all of the graphic symbols, and I can kind of scroll through with my cursor just to see what this will look like as a preview because I've named them appropriately. So what we're going to do is drag walk 01 on, and you're going to see that it is quite large. So the stage is basically, in my case, the same height as my character. So I want to make sure that there is some room for my character to walk. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to the properties, click on the desk or the canvas here, and then I am going to change the size. So I'm going to want to make sure that he has some room to walk, so I'm going to double this, so up to 1,100, and for the height I'm going to double that as well, so go up to 800. Okay. And now I get the problem here is that this is quite large and I can't see everything, so this is where I'm going to use the zoom tool. And I'm going to go to fit in window. So whatever I have, it's going to fit it in here. So I'm going to move my character about here. And don't worry about anything that overlaps the gray area around the stage, because that's just not going to be viewed in a published video file anyway. So what we're going to do is on each frame, we're going to need to put another motion frame for this. So on frame 2, what I'm going to do is control click, and I'm going to insert a blank keyframe, go to the library, and then put number 2 in. Now the problem here is that I can't exactly see where the original one was, so this is where I'm going to be using the onion skin tool to kind of line it up. So you can sort of guess. But try and overlap the second image partially on top of the first one, because if you think about it, if you're walking, your paces aren't that much larger than your torso size. So these should actually be going quite slowly. So I'm going to keep going through here, control click, blank keyframe, position 3. Put that one in, and just keep going like this until you get to the other side of the stage. This should take probably a lot of frames to do that. Try and get somewhere at least 32, and that'll make the next part interesting. So go ahead and do that, and then I'll show you what it looks like when you've finished your walk. Okay, now that you've got your character walking from one side to the other, we can take a look at how that looks by scrubbing through by dragging the playhead here. But I'm just going to hit the play button here, and we'll take a look at some of the navigation tools down here on the timeline. So I'm going to hit play. Now, for me, that moved very quickly, so I'm not entirely happy with my frame rate here. So I'm going to click on frames per second. We've seen this in a previous tutorial in the properties, but you can also get access to it here. So I'm going to change this to 12 frames per second. A few other things that we can see here is this is the elapsed time. So right now it's 2.6 seconds long. If I were to change this to 6, see that it doubles to 5.2. So I'm going to keep mine at 12. Find the proper frame rate for your own project. And then over here also it tells you which frame you're on. So you can drag this back and forth to scrub, which is really not very intuitive to me. But you can jump to a particular frame if you type in a number and then hit return. So I'm going to play again. Okay, this looks pretty good. Couple other things for navigation here. This one is go to first frame, go to last frame, and then we're going to make use of the move forward one frame and then move backward one frame. So I'm going to go forward, and usually you can see maybe where you might have made some errors by going one frame at a time this way. So I can see that my character is sort of jumping up from time to time. This one I want to move them a little bit forward, so I'm going to use the arrow keys on the keyboard, and each one nudges the image one pixel at a time. So that's okay. I can see that he kind of goes down a little bit here, so you can click and move up. In future tutorials, we're going to use guides that would clean up something like this, but we're just learning the basics now. So go through a little bit at a time. Oh, that's a huge jump. So now if you want to move him more dramatically than one frame at a time, you can hold the shift button down, and you can see instead of moving, this is one frame, and then instead of moving it one frame at a time when you hold shift, it'll move 5 frames. So I kind of want to be somewhere between there, and then I'll just keep going through. See, clearly this should be maybe down and a little bit to the left, so I'm going to shift down, go left a few frame or a few pixels, and move this one forward a little bit. Okay, so go fix up your timeline. Maybe I'll show you a few other things that you can use to help you a bit. One thing is the onion skin. We've looked at that before. So if we drag around, we can sort of see not only the frame we're on, but a couple frames before and a couple frames after. Now this is a little bit confusing because I like to see maybe where I've come from instead of where I'm going. So you can use the right hand handle here. So now it views the frame that you're on and two prior. You want to see the ones where you're going, you can organize it like this. So find the degree to which you want that extended. If you don't want to use the onion skins because you don't want to see the whole character, just sort of generally where the images are, you can use onion skin outlines. And if you can see, there's a faint sort of box around this. And I can change this layer's color by clicking, well, I'll just leave it as green right now. But you can see the little outline here. And because the character is in different sort of places in the middle of the images that I took, it's maybe not the best judge. Sometimes I want to do something though where I have to move a chunk of the animation. That's where you'd use edit multiple frames. So edit multiple frames, you can see it actually looks pretty much like we've got the actual image. It's not that ghost form. And this tells you you can actually edit more than one frame at a time. So if I don't like this area, this whole area I've decided is maybe a little too far over, I can select them. You can see that every frame here on the timeline is selected. I've selected all those images, and then you can bulk move them. So I liked this part of the animation, but the whole thing should have been a little bit more to the right maybe, so I can just nudge that a little bit to the right or down or up, whatever I want. I'm actually going to put it back. The other thing that we get down here that's really useful is the modify markers. What we can do is we can change the range. So this is looking at two frames ahead, two frames back. This is five frames in either direction. I can mark the whole range, and I'll show you a little bit more with onion skin because it's a little more dramatic than edit multiple. Other things we can do here, I can anchor the marker. So if I go to 2, what I can do is anchor the marker, because this is the region that I care about. So when I'm outside the region, I don't see any extra frames. But as soon as I step back into the region, you can see that my range has been anchored here. So if this is great when you really want to edit one part and ignore the rest. Also, we could do always show marker, which isn't initially obvious what it does, but if I take the onion skin off, there's no reason that it should be showing me this range because I don't have anything that I'm viewing, but always show markers always shows your markers. The other two things down here are the center frame and loop. Loop does a loop within an area. So if I play this, what it's going to do is it's going to play one area of the animation over and over again, which is great if you're trying to fix up one section. Also, the center frame isn't immediately obvious what it does. I'm just going to take away my anchor and then take away the always show. The center frame here, what it does is if I drag, maybe scroll ahead, my animation has say 500 frames. What I can do is click the center frame and it will bring me back to wherever the playhead actually was. So go ahead and fix up your animation here and then we'll move on to the next step. Okay, so what we did in this video was we created a walking character using a frame-by-frame animation. We imported images to the stage, and we used symbols in the library and looked at several timeline controls that we hadn't seen before. Now, as far as the next step goes, what we're going to be doing next, if you click on this link, is we're going to combine a motion tween with frame-by-frame animation. That'll help us clean up a bunch of stuff in the frame-by-frame and also make the next step a little bit easier.